In your Section Workspace, you can create, organize, and edit your pages. Let's take a look. New Page allows you to create a new page. Organize Pages allows you to drag and drop your pages to change the order or to create a hierarchy. The Recycle Bin stores pages that you've removed until you're ready to permanently delete them. The Page Search feature comes in handy if you have many pages in your section. In your Section Workspace, you'll also see a Current Pages block, quick links to common tools, and a snapshot of total visits to your workspace on the end-user website. If your district has either blogs or the social media framework, you'll also see a block for pending comments. This will allow you to approve, review, or decline comments right in your workspace. There are additional one-click access links in the Common Tools and Pending Comments. In Common Tools, selecting All Tools takes you to the Tools tab. Under Pending Comments, selecting All Comments opens the Approve Visitor Comments window, also found in the Tools tab. The green status button next to a page signifies that the page is currently active. This button is actually a toggle switch that will toggle between active and inactive. By default, new pages are always active. Selecting the Actions button next to a page allows you to edit the page, set page options, get a link to a page, copy the page, move the page, delete the page, or set viewers. You can also access tabs for tools, editors and viewers, membership, and statistics. On the Tools tab, you can view your section tools and apps. On the Editors and Viewers tab, you can add users or groups who can edit your section or limit who can view it. On the Membership tab, you can select groups of specific users to receive messages from your section. On the Statistics tab, you have access to the statistics for your section. And finally, you can view your website and access help from the top toolbar. And that's the Section Workspace overview. Thanks for watching.